In this lesson, we are going to use the ultrasonic sensor to detect an obstacle and the distance, take action so our car can proceed better with understanding the surrounding. Welcome to Arduino course by Robojax. This course is based on SunFounder 3-in-1 Arduino kit sold on Amazon. Everything that you learn in this course is included in this kit. The course comes with tons of components and projects, all with instruction and video for smart car and other projects that you can use for school or home automation. You can purchase it from sunfounder.com. The kit also comes with full documentation, code download, learning projects with full explanation, wiring diagram, and the code that you can download. The link to purchase the kit and documentation is below the video in the description. This is the fourth project for smart car. We are using this ultrasonic distance sensor to measure the distance. This way we can detect the obstacle. We have implied two infrared obstacle avoidance, but with this we can also detect two things. We can detect the distance, how far something is, an object, and also we know the existence of an object in this area and a little wider. We had an introduction on ultrasonic sensor and also how to use this motor driver. I expect that you have already watched those videos. Otherwise, please watch them before proceeding with this. The link for those videos are below this video. And here is a documentation page from SunFounder. If you go to car project and number 6, play with ultrasonic module. This is a page where you see the wiring, the code and explanation. And let's have a look at the wiring. This is from SunFounder. So how it works is that we have positive to a breadboard and negative to the breadboard, and we are connecting one wire for the positive, the other for the negative, and the ping and echo wires are connected to pin 3 and 4. On our system, the positive is connected from this pin, from here to this point where we have positive, and then from here we have ground. So these are all our ground. And this is our ultrasonic sensor. We are just putting it, inserting it on the breadboard somewhere at the middle so it faces this way. And here, this is exactly at the middle. One hole left or right doesn't matter, but this is at the right. The first one, positive, goes to positive. I'm moving my wires so we can have one more positive. So that is my positive in here. And the negative, the last pin is negative. So this is one line I can connect anywhere, and I'm connecting it to this point. So that is negative. And the right pin is green. Second pin, I've connected to the second pin, and this goes to pin 3 of Arduino. And here, pin 3, and the second pin from the left here, this will go to pin 4. So the wiring is completed. Now let's open the project, click on File, open, go to the SunFounder download page, click on car project, then number 6, ultrasonic module, click and open it. Let me explain the code. We have already seen this code in previous lesson. These are for the motor control, and then we have trigger pin and echo pin, which we have studied in the introduction to ultrasonic sensor. We are initializing the serial monitor with 9600 baud, and then the two motors. This is for the first motor for the right, that's for the left, and this is for ultrasonic. For ping pin and trigger pin, one is as an input, the other as an output. We already have seen this. And inside the loop, this is where the action takes place. This function read sensor data is a function at the bottom of the code which reads the distance and returns it. And the result of this, whatever it is, we are storing it in this variable called distance of type float. And this line is a conditional statement. We say if this distance is greater than 25, that is centimeter, then which means the obstacle is further away, so move forward. We go forward with a speed 200. Remember, the speed is from 0 to 255. So 255 means 100%. We already done it in the introduction. I spoke about it. So this is just sending the car with that speed. Else if, otherwise, if the distance is less than 10, okay, or greater than 2, which means between 2 and 10, then move backwards. Else, stop. So otherwise, it will stop. This is a function. This is another function, forward, backward, move, stop, move. So this is a function that reads the data, and the result is returned using this variable. We have already spoken about this. So we are setting the trig pin as low for 2 microseconds, and then setting it to high, the trig pin for 10 seconds, and then trig pin low. Then we read pulse in, we pass that trig pin with high, so this is reading and dividing it by 58, which is getting the, based on speed of light, speed of sound, we are getting the distance, and distance is returned. Move forward is, when we pass that speed, it comes here, so we are controlling, this is for one motor, this is for another motor, that's forward. For backward, these two at the middle which have speed will be 0, and the top and bottom, which were 0, and now they are in speed, so the motor will rotate in the other direction. And for stop, we are just sending 0, 0 to all 4 pins, which I mentioned, these two is for right side, and this is for the left side, for motor A and motor B, the motor will stop. On each function, I've added this text, so it will tell us if the function is running. For when it goes to backward, we see reverse. When it moves forward, we see forward and stopped. Now I'm uploading the code and just disconnecting negative ground pin from this motor driver and then programming it. The code is loaded. Let me open the serial monitor. As you can see, it says forward or stopped, forward, stopped, because there is certain distance. I have to make sure. Now, if I bring my hand, it says reverse. Otherwise, it goes forward and Y forward and stop. When you run the program and if you see this error which says move forward was not declared in this scope, for example, in this line it stopped, or it stops at this, I have added this, each function, this is called prototype. So before the setup, we have to add each of these with open, close, and the semicolon like this. So these are called prototype. We have already spoken when we declared or learned about functions, so the program will know that this function exists below the code. Now Now let's upload the code. The error disappeared. Now let's open the serial monitor. So it reads the distance 0 and applies the stop. Why? And when I run this code, pay attention here. We are reading forward and then stop. Let me stop this by clicking on auto scroll. You see, it reads 0. That's why it has to apply the stop. And then it reads 36, forward, and then 0, even though this is not being moved. There is an object in front of it, so it's reading. And let's solve this. The reason that we are getting that error is when we are reading this in the loop, we are doing it very quickly. The loop ends and it goes back. An ultrasonic sensor does not have enough time to read it. For that reason, we need to have a delay, let's say delay of 100 milliseconds, and it will resolve the problem. Now, let me upload it and show you. Now look at the serial monitor. Now this is hitting an object and the distance is coming. It's more than 36, greater than 36, 25 centimeter. And as you can see, we don't get any stop. So it consistently works perfectly. And now here is the demonstration. As you can see, because the distance is greater than 25 centimeter, now if I put my hand and it's less than 25, so it stopped. Let me bring it. It goes reverse because it's less than 10, and here it stops. 16, 17, and less than that, it goes reverse. And now let's demonstrate it. This is more than 25 centimeter and it's facing the obstacle. Let me connect the power, and Arduino ground wire is not connected, so that's connected, and let's power up. Okay, so now it's facing and stopped because it's less than 25. And if I go further, it goes further. But if I bring it closer, it goes backwards. And as you can see, the code is working perfectly, and our car is really smart at the moment.